question was from Strix, and the other question was from Hashmap. Team me with six random students from all over India, and we were given 2 days to like know each other, what skills we have. So they, even if you have not won the hackathon, you have chances for getting an internship at JP Morgan. Even I did not won the hackathon. So these mentors are the only one who will be going to tell the HR which student to select for the internship.
Hi everyone, thank you so much for such an amazing response to all the videos that you're showing. I am back again with the 5th episode of Let's Talk Internship series, and in this Let's Talk Internship series I have a special company for today, that is JP Morgan and Chase. So let me tell you brief about JP Morgan and Chase. So JP Morgan and Chase is basically a American multinational financial investment bank. So like it has various profiles, like we'll discuss each and everything about this company, and I have one special guest in this episode. She'll discuss about her complete recruitment procedure. Even when she was in her second year, the process started, and by the end of her second year, she got an internship in JP Morgan and Chase through their very great and unique platform known as Code for Good. So we'll discuss each and everything about JP Morgan and Chase, like what is the eligibility criteria for this hackathon, what is the CTC, what are the requirements that you should have, like what is the importance of the test, and like each and everything we'll discuss in this episode, and like you'll have a clear cut view of what JP Morgan Chase is looking forward to in this hackathon, that is Code for Good. So when you talk about the important things about this JP Morgan and Chase, so first of all, let's talk about the various profiles of JP Morgan Chase. So it hires basically for two profiles, that is quantitative research analyst and software development engineer. So when you talk about its CTC and its package in colleges, so it varies from IITs, GTU bits and normal tier 2, tier 3 colleges. Like in some colleges, like the package for a quantitative research analyst profile is 31 LPA and its base is close to 21 lakhs per annum. So that is really very great, and like it's, I would say, one of the highest packages that a company offers. The base salary is 21 LPAs, huge amount. Next, when we talk about the software development engineer role, so for software development engineer role, the salary, like the CTC for IITs, GTU bits, it's close to 25 LPA, and the in-hand package is 16 base. The 16 base salary is there for them. And when we talk about tier 2, like NITs or other colleges, so they offer a package of 14 LPA for software developer role, and the base salary is close to 11.5 or 12 lakhs per annum. So this is also pretty amazing when we talk about this particular company, and the stipend that it offers for internships is also, like, it varies from college to college. Like for IITs and DTU bits, like for them it's 75,000 per month, and for other colleges it's 50,000 per month. So stipend is also pretty amazing. Along with that, when you talk about the work culture and how it recruits, it is one of the unique ways in India that how what is the recruitment procedure and strategy of JP Morgan and Chase. We'll discuss each and everything about the recruitment procedure, the strategy. But in this episode, I have with me Soumya Oja. She's a third year undergraduate from VIT Vellore, and she'll discuss each and everything about her journey to JP Morgan Chase through their hackathon Code for Good. The episode is a bit long because she has discussed it entirely in description, along with the type of questions that they have asked in various rounds and how you should prepare for it if you're aiming at cracking JP Morgan and Chase. So go through this episode completely, and like definitely you will get a lot of things into why this hackathon is very special. Like there are no interviews for getting an internship. Direct mentor review plays a part. Like the mentor review is final, that will help you get this internship. Like there are no separate interviews for this role. So there are a lot of important things and insights into this JP Morgan Chase journey, and we have discussed it pretty brief, and let's see what Soumya has to say about her journey.
Thank you so much, Soumya, for accepting the invitation and coming here for sharing your journey. But before we start with the actual application process, like we'd like to know a bit about you.
Hello everyone, this is Soumya Oja from VIT Chennai campus, 1822 batch from CSE branch. Recently, I have got an internship opportunity from JP Morgan Chase and Company through the Code for Good event. And now I will be sharing my experience of how I grabbed an internship opportunity from JP Morgan Chase and Company. So stay tuned to hear my experience.
So like before we move on to the actual process, like we'd like to know more bit about you, like your college life, what you did in past 2 years of your college life, whether you were part of certain clubs, societies, and how, like, what was your journey of 2 years in college?
I'm not that kind of a person who is like involved in so many clubs in college. But yeah, I have joined a few clubs, like dancing and all. I used to practice, that is my passion. So I will say that just you should go after your passion as well as you study in college also. But one thing I would like to share about my college life was, when I was in class 11-12, I was not so good in computers. And when I took this course of CSC in VIT, then I thought that I had taken this branch of CSC, so I have to be good in this because this is what I have to do in my life. So what I thought was, at the time when I will be at par with other students, when we will be like preparing for the companies and all, so I have to prepare a bit early, because when that time will come, I know that I won't be at par with them because I was not so good like others and all. So from my first semester only, I used to do a bit of coding and all. And also we had like Python subject in our first semester. So I used to do some kind of problems, like easy level only, but I used to practice something from HackerRank and all, so that I had a good base. And that the time by when the companies used to come, I will be at the same level as others who are so good in computers and coding and all. So this is what something which I inculcated in my college life, because I was not good at it and I wanted to be good at it. And later on, I found that coding was not only I did just for getting a good job or something. I love doing it. I like finding solutions. And so I discovered my love for coding. Yeah.
That's perfectly amazing to hear, Shamya. Like, we'll move on to the process, like, for which everybody has been waiting for. So, like, how did you get to know about this opportunity? Like, was it an on-campus opportunity or it was an off-campus opportunity?
Yeah, this company, JP Morgan Chase, they recruit people through this Code for Good event. So they will be coming to a few colleges in India, and they usually come for both internship and full-time opportunity. So during my time, they came when I was in second year. Fourth semester in the month of January. They usually start their recruitment process in the month of January. So they came to our campus.
Overall, like, we'd like to know more about the process, like, what were the number of rounds and like what was being asked in each round. So like, how did you go about, like, you were in your fourth semester when this opportunity came, and like by fourth semester generally students are not much prepared about placements and internships. So how everything went, and like, we'd like to know more about that.
Yeah, so this is what I was sharing in the beginning also. Like, I was doing a bit of coding from my first semester only. So by the first year, I had this knowledge of, I had a good knowledge in languages, C++ and C. And I could solve like problems and all using languages, and basic problems I was able to solve. Then one of my senior told me about this Coding Ninjas course. It's not compulsory you take this course, but he recommended me because I asked him that I want to have a proper guidance in DSA and all. So in the summer vacation after my first year, I took this course. That taught me a very good base in data structures and algorithms. And I am a kind of person who believes that if I don't study for mask or of a company or something, I usually believe that we must have a good base in whatever we study. So I took this course and had a very good base after studying that in data structures and algorithms. And it's a compulsory you take this course. You can have this knowledge from anywhere on YouTube also. There are so many good channels now available on YouTube. So you can study from there also. And so I completed my DSA part in the summer vacation. And after that, when the college reopened in the second year, I used to solve some problems again from HackerRank or LeetCode. LeetCode is also a very good platform for like practicing problems and all. So I used to practice problems on there. And I had no idea that in the second year, I will be getting to like participate in the recruitment process of a company. So that was totally new for me. And I was not prepared for it also. So when I came to know that this company came in January, first of all, I was thinking that I won't be sitting for it, because I did not prepare anything, and it was totally new for me, because I never thought that companies will be coming in second year only. But I thought, let's give it a try. I will tell this thing that you should never back off. You should always give a try. Even if you are not prepared, just go and give it a try, because that will give you an experience of a lifetime. So you will get something out of it. Nothing is anytime wasted. Okay. So I just went there. I didn't have anything in my mind of getting shortlisted or something like that. I just went there, and So the coding, there were only two coding questions there and 10 MCQs. So the coding questions were like simple for me, because I was doing it for in the first semester, so it was kind of easy only. They did not ask like very advanced data structures and all, because they also knew that the students are from second year only. So they asked like basic data structures like linked lists and all. They won't go beyond, I guess, trees. I don't think they asked trees also, like basic data structures and linked list, and linked list will be fine till that. And a very basic data structure like array questions. So only till this you will be getting questions. I will be telling what question I got. One question was from strings and the other question was from hash map. So they asked basic data structures only for internship students. Okay. For full-time students, they will be asking you the advanced data structures like DP, graph and all. But for internship students, it's a bit easy compared to that. So they will be asking you the basic data structures only. So, yeah.
Yeah. So this was basically the first round that was the online coding as well as MCQs round, right? So when you talk about the MCQs, what was the main topics in that MCQ? Were they CS fundamentals or just aptitude?
Yeah, no, they didn't include aptitude in that. It was just what will be the output of this coding question. So it was basically purely based on coding and languages. I will say C++, whatever language you have opted for, they will be asking you what will be the output for this part of a statement. So that was also easy only. If you have been doing coding, then you will be knowing that this will be the output for this, if you have studied the languages well. So that was also easy. So you don't need to panic enough in this round, because it's easy only if you have been practicing like recently. So it will go.
Yeah. So after this coding round, so like what were the other rounds? Like, was there a shortlisting after this round, and like how many students like went into the next round, and like what was the next process?
I think the cutoff criteria was like if you have solved 1.5 coding question. I don't know about the MCQ part, but 1.5 question if you have solved, you were selected in the next round for the video interview. And the next round was a video interview round, where what you need to do is you need to like log into a system which is your HireVue platform. So there you need to record a video of yourself, and they will be asking you 2 random questions. You won't be knowing what questions they are asking. So it will be completely random for you. And the questions are not technical or something. They are just purely based on behavioral round. It's kind of a behavioral round. They will be asking you questions which will describe you as a person to them. Like I will be telling you one question which I got. They asked me like, if you know a concept very well and your friend does not know that concept well, then what will you do in that situation? So you have to answer like you will help him or something. You don't. So you have to be positive in this round. Tell all the positive things, and they want to see just what kind of a person you are, because in JP Morgan, it really matters. They see all these personal qualities and all, team skills and all. So it really matters what you answer in that round, because many people were rejected in that round also. And one thing I will suggest is they also look on your communication skills also. So be confident. It's not like you have to be very fluent in English or something, but you have to be confident in whatever you say and be positive. So that will help you clear the round. Yeah.
Okay. So like this was basically a type of, we can say, a brief HR round in which you were asked 1 or 2 HR type or managerial questions just to check your communication skills, just to like getting to know more about you, your personal skills, like that kind of.
Yeah.
So like after this round also shortlisting was done?
Yeah, this round, after this round shortlisting was done. And then students were selected for the main event, which is the Code for Good event, their main hackathon event. So I will be describing about this hackathon. So what happens in this hackathon is they will be selecting students from all over India, whatever universities they go. So they will be selecting all the students for this final round. And then they will be pairing you up with random students from any university. And it's very sure that you won't be getting a student from the same university in your group. Okay. So there will be students from all over India, and they like this time it was firstly virtual. It never happened virtual hackathon till now. So this was the first virtual hackathon they had this year. So they like teamed me with six random students from all over India, and we were given 2 days to like know each other, what skills we have. So they gave us 2 days to know each other, and each team is assigned with 2 mentors who are from the same company. And the role of these mentors is to look after all the students, like who have done what contribution to the team, how has he helped in making the product and all. So this was about the team part. You will be getting to know your team 2 days before the main event. So make sure that you know the skills of all, and you have to like put the skills of everyone in the product which you make on the final day. So now I will be speaking about the final event. So when the final event happens is there will be many NGOs coming to you, and they will be describing your problem statement. Okay, so then you need to like select top 3 problem statements which you want to develop and product for, and then according to the first come first, they will be giving you your problem statement. So it may be that you won't get your first preference, but you might be getting your second or third preference. Then you have to work as a team and build the product in 8 hours. They'll be giving you 8 hours only, and so you have to develop the product in 8 hours, and after that you will be having a judging round where they will be selecting like top 3 teams in the final for each NGO. So for each NGO, 3 teams will be selected in the final, and after the finals, again there will be a judging round in which higher officials from JP Morgan will be coming to see your product, and then they will be declaring the final winners of this hackathon for each NGO. So this was the hackathon part, but one thing which is quite unique in this hackathon is mostly hackathons, like the students who win, they only get the internship, but this does not happen in JP Morgan. It is not sure that if you have won the hackathon, you are guaranteed an internship in JP Morgan Chase. It is not sure. It all depends on what you have done in your team. Even if you have not won the hackathon, you have chances for getting an internship at JP Morgan. Even I did not win the hackathon. I was a finalist, but did not win it. But still, I got an internship opportunity because it does not matter to them you have won it or not. What matters to them is how much you contributed to your team and what all skills you know, what are your team skills, your way of communication. Way of communication matters a lot in this company. So make sure you pitch your ideas. When you are pitching ideas like what we should make in a product, you have to like speak up, because they will be seeing that which person has pitched what ideas and all. So they will be taking that also into consideration. And during the judging round also, make sure that you speak up your points so that the mentors will be knowing that what all you have done. And just keep telling the mentors what part you are doing in this product, and make sure that you contribute to the GitHub profile also, because they will be making a GitHub profile for each of the teams. And at the end of the hackathon, they will be seeing how much each person has contributed to that GitHub profile. So make sure that you make some contributions in that GitHub profile, because these mentors are only the ones who will be telling the HR that this student was good, he has this skills, this communication skills. So they will be the one who will be telling the HR that this student is perfect for an internship at JP Morgan. So make sure that you perform well in front of your mentors. That's what I will say.
Yeah, so that was pretty good to hear. It was a unique concept that JP Morgan is following for this hackathon.
Yeah.
So, but if for example, a student is in second year. So from the point of view of this particular hackathon, do you think any particular skills that he should have or anything related to development field? So what are things that you think should a person who is aiming at performing good in this hackathon should have those skills?
I don't think that you have to be so good in web development, because they understand that each student cannot be so good in coding also and web development also. They truly understand this. What you have to do is whatever you know, whatever part it is, either it is small or not, you have to just show them what contribution you have done. Like even if it's just the HTML, CSS, Bootstrap, JavaScript, anything, you need to tell them that this is the part which I did. And they will be happy with it. They won't tell you that this is a very small part which you have done or something. whatever you know, just do it perfectly fine and just tell them that you have done this thing. So it's not compulsory for you to know the back end things or all or the front end. It's good if you know all the front end, and if you don't know the front end, just be a bit good in the back end. So I would suggest that if you're good in front end, that's fine. You don't need to learn the back end things or all. And if you're not so good in front end but good in back end, so that will also do. Anyone, either of them will do. So yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So one thing more, like for the internship offer, like the decision is the decision only by the mentor's review, or any some exit interviews are also taken at the end?
No. This hackathon was the final round. After that, they will be giving you the final list of the selected students for the internship. So these mentors are the only one who will be going to tell the HR which student to select for the internship.
Sure. Okay. So that was like really a great experience. Like those who have been a part of this, they might have known the experience, like how great it is to be a part of like a team of random people from all over India and coming together, yeah, collaborating on a particular thing and then building a product in 8 hours. That's the most important. So like, yeah, it would have been really, really exciting.
Yeah, that's the main issue also, because all are random people. So you don't know what skills they possess. So it's very difficult to like, because someone knows Node.js, someone knows Django. So it becomes very difficult to like collaborate all in one product, but you have to do it anyhow. So yeah.
So that was great insights into the entire process of this hackathon. Like, let's move on to like, particular preparation strategy. Like if a person is there in his first year, so if he starts aiming at JPMC, so what things that he should have in his skill set, or like, although we have discussed, but if you would like to know more, like we would like to know more about the same, like the importance of CS fundamentals, importance of projects and everything.
Okay, so for JPMC, I think that in the first year, you don't need to like stress so much on coding or something. You just learn the basic languages also. Any one language will be fine. You don't need to learn all the languages. Just be good in that one language. So I will suggest that in the first year, you can just complete one language very proper. It can be either CPP or Java. These are the most frequent languages being used. So, and do some questions on the HackerRank platform with these languages only, because then you will be having very basic ways of doing questions, like basic questions you are able to do some thinking, because that will develop your thinking also, and thinking matters a lot in coding, as we all know. So this will this will make your thinking proper. Then after your first year, we get a summer vacation. So in that, we get plenty amount of time to like know the basics very well. So I will suggest that if you can complete the DSA part in the summer vacation, because you have got so much of time, you have nothing else to do, so you can just focus on that and complete the data structures part, just the basics, knowing all the data structures, where they are used, and the data structures basic questions like how the linked lists are used, what properties, and all those questions. Like, and after the summer vacation is over, then you can just practice these questions of this data structures from either Geek4Geeks, LeetCode, or HackerRank. Any platform will be fine, whatever you like. And I think this much preparation will be enough for JPMC, because they don't ask like so tough questions for the interns. They just ask questions to know that whether you know how to use the data structures properly. And that part of a thing will do. And the second question, one question will be from a data structure, and that will be very direct, that they will give you exactly what you have to do. And the second question will be a story type question, but that will be from a data structure like array or string. So that question tests your thinking skill, and the first question tests how you know to use the data structure. So just the thinking skill and how to use the data structure, all this will do. So you don't need to panic so much for this amount of preparation will let you like clear the first round very well. I'm sure of that.
So like for any hiring process, we generally discuss about the resume, like resume is an important part of the process. So was resume a part of this process, entire process, like in between anywhere, like resume played a part?
I don't think so, because as these companies are recruiting from specific universities, So they basically select all the students who are eligible for their eligibility criteria or satisfy the eligibility criteria. So there is nothing like they are so strict on the resume part. If you have a decent resume, you will be selected for the next round. Basically, you just need to qualify the eligibility criteria. Like there is 7 CGPA, minimum 7 CGPA you need to have, and some percentage of marks in class 12 or something. And okay. No back in any subject. So all that will help you to be selected in the next round.
Okay. So that was really a very insightful journey for the JP Morgan Chase Code for Good Hackathon. At the last, I would like to know, like, any piece of advice you would like to give to anybody who is aiming at cracking this particular hackathon and getting an internship offer or full-time offer from JPMC?
Okay. One piece of advice I will give is, many people are good at coding, but still they are not able to qualify for this JPMC internship. The main reason behind this is because these people not only aim for your skills also, but also for your personal skills. So you need to show your team skills, you need to speak up, you need to you have to be friendly with your teammates, because they will be seeing that you are interacting with others. You don't have to be always sitting, not speaking with anyone, not interacting with others. They won't like this kind of a nature. So you have to be interactive in a way, and your communication skills also matter, as I was always saying. So just be good in your communication, and show your personal skills also, because they know that you are good in coding, but they need this personal skills and communication skills along with that, and that will only help you to get that internship finally from JPMC.
That is super amazing to hear. Like, the entire journey was totally like motivating to anybody who is thinking of cracking this internship and participating in such hackathons. So thank you so much, Soumya, once again for coming here and sharing your journey. And I hope this journey would be really insightful and would be beneficial to those coming people who are like aiming at cracking JPMC. Thank you once again.
Thank you so much. It was my pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me.
I hope this episode gave you a great insights into JP Morgan Chase Code for Good Hackathon and how you can get into this amazing company with a very amazing CTC. So for more such amazing opportunities, do subscribe to this channel, like this video, and share it with your friends. And thank you. Good luck. Bye-bye.